Boeing's CEO finally admitting to the company's mistakes following last week's mid-air panel blowout on an Alaska Airlines flight. Dave Calhoun vows transparency on the matter, adding they will ensure the safety of other Boeing planes. The statements were Boeing's first public acknowledgement of error since the incident left the 737 MAX 9 plane with a gaping hole. Alaska Airlines and United Airlines have found loose parts on similar aircraft, raising fears such an incident could have happened again. Israel's top court rejects an appeal by international media organizations for access into the Gaza Strip. Israel controls entry to the besieged enclave and has not allowed journalists to travel there independently. The Supreme Court argued allowing journalists to enter could endanger Israeli troops as they could give away operational details. The Foreign Press Association in Jerusalem said it was disappointed by that ruling. Washington believes the daily toll of the war in Gaza is too high. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken says Palestinians must be allowed to return home as soon as conditions allow. He adds Arab leaders are ready to invest in the future of Gaza, but only if there's a clear pathway to a Palestinian state.
We know that facing an enemy that embeds itself among civilians, who hides in and fires from schools, from hospitals, makes this incredibly challenging. But the daily toll on civilians in Gaza, particularly on children, is far too high. We want this war to end as soon as possible. There's been far too much loss of life, far too much suffering. But it's vital that Israel achieve its very legitimate objectives of ensuring that October 7th can never happen again. We know that.
Blinken also weighed in on South Africa's genocide charge against Israel, calling it meritless.
We believe the submission against Israel to the International Court of Justice distracts the world from all of these important efforts. And moreover, the charge of genocide is meritless. It's particularly galling given that those who are attacking Israel, Hamas, Hezbollah, the Houthis, as well as their supporter Iran, continue to openly call for the annihilation of Israel and the mass murder of Jews.
Palestine's ambassador to the UN stressing the Arab group's continued effort to seek a ceasefire between Israel and Hamas. International concern has mounted over the huge Palestinian death toll from the Israeli assault on the enclave. Israel's air and ground offensive, prompted by a cross-border Hamas rampage in October last year, has now killed over 23,000 Palestinians.
Continue to knock on the door of the General Assembly, the Security Council, the Secretary General, Madam Kaag Sigrid, and every component of the United Nations to accomplish the ceasefire. We always welcome any possibility of any outcome that gets us closer to the ceasefire. This is our compass. Everything we do, it has to lead us in the direction of a ceasefire.
The International Criminal Court investigates the deaths of journalists covering the war in Gaza. Media advocacy group Reporters Without Borders filed a complaint with the ICC last year, alleging war crimes over the deaths of the journalists. Based on the record of the Committee to Protect Journalists, at least 79 media professionals have been killed since the war erupted. Chaos erupts in Ecuador. Masked gunmen broke into a live television studio and threatened staff members. The attackers were later seen leaving the studio, reportedly with several hostages. Police have arrested at least 13 gunmen. Elsewhere in that country, at least 7 police officers were kidnapped by criminal gangs. Explosions also reported in several cities. President Daniel Noboa on Monday declared a 60-day state of emergency after a notorious gang leader disappeared from his jail cell. Noboa has also declared an internal armed conflict and identified nearly 24 gangs as terrorist groups. New details emerging on the health condition of U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin. In a statement, the Walter Reed National Military Medical Center said Austin is being treated for prostate cancer. It adds he suffered complications that led to his hospitalization on New Year's Day. The cancer was discovered in early December. The Pentagon has faced backlash over the secrecy on Austin's hospitalization, with even U.S. President Joe Biden kept in the dark.
This review will help us understand where we can do better in terms of making sure that part of the notification timeline, not only to include the chain of command, but also the public notification timeline, is taken into account in terms of how we, the timeline and how we get to where we're at the point of, okay, it's time to let the public know. You know, clearly, we could have done better, and we will do better.
French President Emmanuel Macron names 34-year-old Education Minister Gabriel Attal as the country's new prime minister. This makes Attal France's youngest and first openly gay prime minister. His appointment won't lead to any major political shift, but it signals a desire by Macron to move beyond last year's unpopular pension and immigration reforms ahead of the European Parliament elections. Snow sculptures from around the world add the final touches to their creations in northern China. The international competition has returned for the first time in Harbin since borders were shut in 2020 due to the pandemic. Artists came from 12 different countries, including Russia, South Korea, Canada, and even tropical Indonesia. The competition is part of the Ice and Snow Festival, which officially opened January 5. Harbin has seen a boom in winter tourism this season, with record numbers of visitors and revenue. Two U.S. celebrities come to the defense of Joe Coy after the Philo-American comedian received intense backlash for his hosting of the Golden Globes. Our North America Bureau Chief T.J. Manotok tells us more.
One day after his historic hosting of the Golden Globes Awards, Philam comedian Joe Coy finally speaks out after getting mixed reviews from his performance. In an interview with ABC News' morning show Good Morning America, Coy admitted that he was hurt with the criticisms that have come his way. Joe Coy stressed how hard it was for a stand-up comic to be tasked to host a major awards show just 10 days before. He added that the lowest moment he felt was when his joke about Taylor Swift and the NFL fell flat, and insisted that the joke was supposed to be poking fun on the NFL and not on Swift. Amidst avalanche of criticism, there were those who have come out to support Joe Coy. Fellow stand-up comedian Keith Pedro says being an award show host is hands down the hardest thing for comics to do.
A Hollywood award show? Yeah, very difficult. It's the hardest. You're performing for arenas for people who are there to see you. Now you have to switch up and perform for the most self-absorbed people in the planet.
Pedro adds, given the time he had to prepare, Coy still did a good job, but also stressed that maybe it's time to reconsider if comedians are still the right choice for the job.
I thought it was funny when he broke character and he was like, yo, this, I didn't write this, the writers wrote this. And everybody's like, oh, you're not supposed to throw the writers under the bus, but the dude got 11 days to prepare for this. I thought that at the end of it all, I thought it was the best that he can do under said circumstances.
Popular radio host Howard Stern echoed the same sentiments and stressed on his podcast that comedians should no longer be hosts if audiences can't appreciate their edgy styles.
And those people in that audience do not want to be made fun of. They're very concerned about their image and their publicist. I mean, if you're shelling out 25, 30% of your income on publicists and agents and managers, you don't want to be goofed on television. You want to be treated like the serious actor, like you're doing the most important shit on the planet. So to go up there and be the host of the Golden Globes, it's a ridiculous gig. You got to sit there.
Veteran actress and TV host Whoopi Goldberg, who had her time as an award show host too, defended Joe Coy, although she admits she did not watch the Golden Globes. She says hosting award shows is not an easy gig. To end this interview, Joe Coy admitted he wanted to give more of himself, but he fell short. And when asked if he would do it again, he was evasive and stressed that he loves his profession more of being a stand-up comedian. TJ Manotok, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles, California.